Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I am Mohammed Yusuf. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Sakhir Palace senior officials of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, heads of missions of the Kingdom of Bahrain abroad, and Kingdom's accredited heads of diplomatic missions on the occasion of the Golden Jubilee of Bahraini Diplomacy and Diplomatic Day, which falls on January 14, 2019. At the beginning of the meeting, the attendees greeted His Majesty the King.
سلام
Thank you. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه، أصحاب السمو، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، أيها السيدات والسادة، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. خير ما نبدأ به حفلنا هذا تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم يتلوها على مسامعنا القارئ علي صلاح عمر.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. للذين استجابوا لربهم الحسنى والذين لم يستجيبوا له لو أن لهم ما في الأرض جميعا ومثله معه لافتدوا به أولئك لهم سوء الحساب ومأواهم جهنم وبئس المهاد. أفمن يعلم أنما أنزل إليك من ربك الحق كمن هو أعمى إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب. الذين يوفون بعهد الله ولا ينقضون الميثاق والذين يصلون ما أمر الله به أن يوصل ويخشون ربهم ويخافون سوء الحساب. والذين صبروا ابتغاء وجه ربهم وأقاموا الصلاة وأنفقوا مما رزقناهم سرا وعلانية ويدرؤون بالحسنة السيئة أولئك لهم عقبى الدار. جنات عدن يدخلونها ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم والملائكة يدخلون عليهم من كل باب. سلام عليكم بما صبرتم فنعم عقب الدار. صدق الله العظيم.
بارك الله فيكم. بارك الله.
يتفضل سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة
His Majesty then delivered a speech on the occasion.
ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعى بإلقاء كلمة سامية بهذه المناسبة.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أصحاب السمو والمعالي، أصحاب السعادة السفراء، نرحب بالجميع أجمل ترحيب، ويسعدنا أن نفتتح عامنا الجديد ببلوغ الذكرى 50 لبدء العمل الدبلوماسي المنظم الذي استطعنا من خلال مسيرته الثرية أن نطلع العالم على الهوية الرصينة لسياسة مملكة البحرين الخارجية الملتزمة بتعزيز التضامن العالمي والارتقاء بالأمن الإنساني. ولقد أوضحت تجاربنا في هذا المجال بقدرة الدبلوماسية البحرينية على التفهم والإدراك التام للمتطلبات وللمتغيرات الدولية بتحدياتها المختلفة، وهو ما مكن بلادنا من التعاطي الدبلوماسي المهني والموضوعي في مختلف الظروف، وصياغة المواقف الخارجية الحريصة على الصالح العام التي تأخذ في الاعتبار التوازن بين أولوياتها الاستراتيجية والتزاماتها الدولية، دون إقفال لأهمية النقل الدقيق لجهود تنميتنا الوطنية المستمرين في تطويرها والتي توثق نتائجها المتقدمة العديد من التقارير الدولية. كما نجحت البحرين عبر نظام عملها الدبلوماسي في بناء شبكة قوية من التحالفات والشراكات الدولية القائمة على أسس احترام سيادة الدول وحسن الجوار، ومد جسور التفاهم وتغريب وجهات النظر في كافة القضايا، وهو أمر يؤكد بأن نهج علاقاتنا الدبلوماسية القائم على حسن النوايا هو ما اعتدنا عليه ولن نتخلى عنه، بكونه فطرة حضارية نشأت عليها الطبيعة البحرينية الودودة والمنفتحة على العالم. وبهذه المناسبة الطيبة يسرنا أن نتوجه بالشكر العميق والامتنان الكبير لمؤسسي العمل الدبلوماسي الوطني ومن يواصل على دربهم لجهودهم الحثيثة في إيصال صوت البحرين الواثق المجسد لصورتها الإيجابية والمرسخ لسياستها الخارجية الداعمة لخير العالم واستقراره، مع تطلعنا لاستمرار جهود التطوير وخصوصا في مجال تنمية الكفاءات واستثمار الخبرات ورفع مستويات التخصصية في العمل الدبلوماسي. ونوجه بهذا الشأن بأن يتم تطوير المعهد الدبلوماسي بتحويله إلى أكاديمية خاصة للدراسات الدبلوماسية، وأن يطلق عليها اسم سمو الشيخ محمد بن مبارك الخليفة. رائد الدبلوماسية البحرينية وأحد مؤسسيها الأوائل، الذي يسجل له تاريخها العريق الإخلاص في الأداء والتميز في العطاء، وهي سمة بحرينية أصيلة نرفع شعارها ونفاخر بها في كل المحافل. وختاماً، ومن منطلق اعتزازنا بما تحققه الدبلوماسية البحرينية وتقديراً للجهود البارزة لكوادرها برجالها ونسائها، نعلن بهذه المناسبة عن تخصيص 14 يناير من كل عام ليكون يوماً خاصاً للسلك الدبلوماسي، ولنحتفي فيه بإنجازاتهم في خدمة البحرين ورفعة شأنها. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Then Deputy Prime Minister His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak delivered a speech in which he expressed pride and appreciation for naming the institute after him. He highlighted that the kingdom celebrates the half century since the establishment of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. He said that this is an opportunity for the ministry's members to meet His Majesty the King and listen to his wise directions for the kingdom's interest and its people. His Highness presented the diplomatic march of the kingdom since the issuance of Decree 1 of the year 1969, issued by the late Sheikh Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa, regarding the establishment of a foreign body that led to establishing the ministry. He said that the day marked continuing the sovereignty of the country after ending the protection agreement with Britain in 1968. His Highness affirmed that the diplomatic march is not measured by number of years, but by the achievements made through regional and international challenges. He praised the directives of His Majesty the King in addressing the border dispute between Bahrain and Qatar, and the International Court of Justice issuing its historic judgment that the Hawar Islands have always been part of Bahrain, with its full sovereignty over the islands in accordance with the international law. He addressed the challenges and threats faced in the region and Bahrain by Iran, and the way the kingdom overcame these challenges, thanks to the negotiations of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa with regional and international countries. His Highness added that the kingdom developed its diplomatic march by following international standards, which developed its relations with various international countries throughout the history of the kingdom. His Highness said that Bahrain's modern diplomatic bureau has been able to keep up with the rapid changes and developments that characterize the field of international relations in recent decades. He asserted that such accomplishments have materialized as a result of the support of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince on the Arab and international levels. His Highness said that the Bureau's work yielded a number of key achievements, such as the selection of Bahrain of being a member of the UN Security Council in the year 1998 to 1999, and Bahrain's presiding over the UN General Assembly in 2007 to 2008 through the appointment of the first Bahraini and Arab woman to occupy such a position. His Highness said that such moments in the history of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs reflect the hard work of Bahrainis on the Arab and international levels. He highlighted that the offices of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs are not a place of comfort and privilege, but are places in which citizens are ever vigilant and ready to defend the interests of their country. His Highness said that as Bahrain celebrates the launch of the diplomatic work and its external relations with international countries are characterized by moderation, good neighborly relations, and a constant willingness to resolve conflicts peacefully, all of which reflect the values of the Bahraini people, such as their openness, hospitality, and generosity. He expressed hope as the ministry enters the second half of the century since its establishment, under the leadership of His Majesty the King, to remain a vehicle for time-honored traditions of international diplomacy as a means for peaceful conflict resolution and cooperation and solidarity between the people on the international level. His Highness said that although the history of the ministry is relatively short, it has experienced many challenges and that its ambitions have pushed it to assert its presence regionally and internationally. He expressed pride in running the ministry for 3.5 decades and have expressed appreciation for the efforts of Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed Al Khalifa for successfully presiding over the ministry. His Highness then wished the ministry further success.
التي حققتها في خضم سياقات وأوضاع دولية وأقليمية كانت سريعة التقلب. وبهذا المعنى فإن عمل وزارة الخارجية الفتية وفي ظل قيادتكم الحكيمة وتوجيهات جلالتكم السامية هي اليوم مفخرة لمملكة البحرين في عهدكم الزاهر بتلك الإنجازات وحيازتها موقعا جديرا بها بين الأمم على الصعيدين الإقليمي والدولي. ويحق لي الإشادة في هذا المقام بتوجيهات وإدارة جلالتكم الحكيمة في معالجة الخلاف الحدودي بين البحرين وقطر وإصدار محكمة العدل الدولية حكمها التاريخي القاضي بتأكيد تبعية جزر حوار كما كانت دائماً للبحرين وبسيادتها التامة على الجزر طبقاً للقانون الدولي. يعيد ذلك إلى ذاكرتنا التحديات والهديدات المتمثلة في الادعاءات والأطماع التوسعية الإيرانية في المنطقة وفي البحرين تحديداً، والتي تم التصدي لها في وقتها بفضل القيادة الحكيمة لصاحب السمو الملكي الأمير خليفة بن سلمان آل خليفة التي أدارت المفاوضات بموازنة مع أطراف إقليمية ودولية توجت بالتأكيد على عروبة البحرين وسيادتها واستقلالها الناجز. إن مملكة البحرين التي استوحت مبادئها ومرجعياتها المؤسسة من الخبرات الدبلوماسية الدولية ومن حضارة وتقاليد شعب البحرين، قد منحتها تلك العناصر المكانة المميزة في علاقاتها على الصعيد الخارجي على امتداد تاريخ البحرين المديد إن شاء الله. لقد استطاع جهازنا الدبلوماسي الحديث وبدعم من صاحب السمو الملك الأمير خليفة بن سلمان آل خليفة رئيس الوزراء الموقر، وصاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد نائب القائد الأعلى النائب الأول لرئيس مجلس الوزراء، مواكبة التحولات والتقلبات التي عرفتها العلاقات الدولية في العقود الأخيرة، مسهماً وفاعلاً إيجابياً على الأصعدة الثنائية والمتعددة، عارضاً وجهات نظر ومبادرات تاريخية هامة لقيت الترحيب والإشادة من قبل الدعوة إلى قيام مجلس التعاون لدول الخليج العربية، وهو الصرح الصامد أمام الظروف التي تواجه منطقة الخليج العربي. صاحب الجلالة، وفي إطار عملها ونشاطها على الساحتين العربية والدولية، فقد تكلل ذلك باختيار البحرين عضواً في مجلس الأمن الدولي عام 1998-1999، وبترأسها للجمعية العامة للأمم المتحدة عام 2007-2008، عندما تبوعت أول امرأة عربية بحرينية ذلك المنصب الدولي الهام. هذه بعض من المحطات الهامة في مسيرة عمل الوزارة وما واجهته خلالها من تحديات عبر فترة قصيرة من الزمن. لقد بذل جنون أوفياء من بناتنا ورجالنا في وزارة الخارجية الجهد الكبير في تنظيم العديد من المؤتمرات والملتقيات العربية والدولية التي استضافتها مملكة البحرين خلال العقود الماضية، غير أن ارتياحنا لأداء المنتسبين للخارجية داخل المملكة وفي الخارج لا يمنعنا من تحفيزهم بكل الوسائل لمضاعفة الجهد والتضحية، نظراً لما تمر به العلاقات الدولية من تعقيدات وتحولات عميقة ومباغتة، وما تفرزه في الوقت الراهن من أزمات وتوترات يصعب التنبؤ دائماً بمداها. إن وزارة الخارجية في كل البلدان ليست مكاتب مريحة وامتيازات كما يتوهم البعض، بل هي في حقيقتها مثل التكنة التي يرابط فيها جنود في أهبة الاستعداد للدفاع عن حمى الوطن بكافة الوسائل. صاحب الجلالة، أصحاب السمو والسعادة والمعالي الحضور الكرام، والمملكة تحتفل اليوم بانطلاق العمل الدبلوماسي يخامرنا اليقين إن علاقاتنا مع الخارج الأقرب والأبعد اتسمت مع العصور بالاعتدال وحسن الجوار والجنوح إلى حل المشاكل بالوسائل السلمية في إطار الحوار المتكافئ. تلك هي بعض المقومات الثابتة لسياستنا الخارجية، وهي ليست غريبة على شعب مملكة البحرين المضياف والمنفتح برحابة على دول وشعوب العالم قاطبة دون تفريط في المبادئ. وإذ تدخل وزارة خارجية النصف الثاني من القرن من عمرها، فإننا ننظر إلى المستقبل بتفاؤل وأمل مع ما يلزم من الحيطة واليقظة، وستظل المملكة في عهد جلالتكم وفية للقيم الرفيعة والتقاليد العريقة والتجارب المضيئة التي أفرزها التراث الدبلوماسي العالمي باعتباره وسيلة للتقارب وفض النزاعات بالطرق السلمية والتعاون والتضامن بين الشعوب. قد يبدو عمر دبلوماسيتنا قصير، وهذا صحيح، لكنه عمر حافل بمواجهات وتحديات فرضها علينا طموحنا لنصبح دولة حاضرة في النظام الدولي والإقليمي وجزءاً فاعلاً من الأسرة العربية والإسلامية. وفي هذه المناسبة فإنه ليسعدني أن أعبر عن اعتزازي البالغ بإدارة وزارة الخارجية لثلاثة عقود، وأن أشيد بما بذله معالي الأخ الشيخ خالد بن أحمد بن محمد آل خليفة من جهود وما قام ويقوم به من دور مشهود في إدارة كفة الوزارة بكل اقتدار ونجاح لما فيه خير وطننا العزيز الذي نعمل لعزته ورفعة شأنه، مع تمنياتي لمعاليه بدام التوفيق. إن تاريخ دبلوماسيتنا لجدير بالتدوين، لنسترجع الأجيال القادمة صفحات مجيدة من معركة بناء الوطن وتمكينه من مقومات السيادة والانخراط في العصر بكل ثقة وتفاؤل وأمل. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
The Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khaled bin Ahmed bin Mohammed, also delivered a speech in which he expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for receiving all of the attendees on this occasion. He stated that Bahraini diplomacy, as a result of the directives and support of His Majesty the King, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, has become a model for effective and active diplomacy, which defends the interests of the kingdom, contributes to establishing its modern aspects, and strengthens its regional and international status. He added that Bahraini diplomacy during the era of His Majesty the King has achieved success in all aspects of development based on its heritage of the principles of national coexistence, mutual respect, joint work, and non-interference policy. The minister affirmed that the successes made in the past 50 years were a result of the elements of success available for Bahraini diplomacy, including leaders who prioritize citizens, people who believe in coexistence, openness, and communication with all people, and competent diplomats who perform their duty optimally. The minister expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for naming the Diplomatic Institute after His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, in appreciation for His Highness's status and achievements in the diplomatic field since the establishment of the ministry, and for dedicating the 14th of January of every year as a day for the diplomatic corps. He affirmed continuing the role of developing the diplomatic work cadres and providing them expertise and knowledge to ensure the continuity of achievements and affirm the success of Bahraini diplomacy regionally and internationally. The minister then presented a commemorative gift to His Majesty the King. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Khir Palace former Foreign Minister and Secretary General of Asila Forum of Morocco and member of the judging committee of Isa Award for Serving Humanity, Mohammed bin Isa. His Majesty praised the bilateral historic relations and praised the efforts of the Jordanian King Mohammed VI in enhancing the relations between the two countries. His Majesty wished Morocco and its people further progress and prosperity. His Majesty also praised the role of Mohammed bin Isa in enhancing the bilateral coordination through his membership in the award and his efforts to achieve its noble goals. His Majesty stressed the importance of spreading cultures in the societies and support individuals' contributions in achieving comprehensive development. Mohammed bin Isa expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King and praised the strong relations between the two countries in all fields. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa chaired today the weekly cabinet meeting, and Secretary General Yasser al-Nasser stated the following. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince directed to enhance the government and parliament cooperation and enhance the cooperation between the executive and legislative authorities. He stressed the need for stronger cooperation between the government and the Representatives Council, especially regarding the government action plan. His Royal Highness also affirmed the importance of achieving economic sustainability and growth to maintain the gains of the citizens and achieve further progress under the reform project of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, as well as achieve the goals of the government led by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness then highlighted the importance of the oil sector in enhancing the national economy and welcomed the signing of the MOU between the National Oil and Gas Authority and the Italian company Eni. Thank you. The cabinet reviewed the government's achievements in the oil and gas sector and the course of work in underway grand capital and development projects in light of ensuring the development of vital establishments in the sector and the sustainability of its competency in the world markets. The cabinet was briefed on the latest stages of oil discoveries projects in various areas of the kingdom. The cabinet approved the agreements and articles of association of the Gulf Payments Company, which was signed in implementation of the decision of the GCC in its 37th session. The cabinet also approved a draft law ratifying the air services agreement between Bahrain and Brunei, signed in the kingdom on November 14th of 2018. Her Royal Highness, the wife of His Majesty the King, President of the Supreme Council for Women, Princess Sabiha bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa, received today at the Council's headquarters the Speaker of the Representatives Council, Fawziya Zainab. Her Royal Highness hailed the achievements of Bahraini women in various domains and their responsible performance in all work fields, which is evident through Zainab's achieving her current position, noting the continuous support of His Majesty the King. She affirmed that a Bahraini woman becoming the head of one of the legislative authorities' councils is an important step in the national march, which will contribute to increasing the achievements of Bahraini women during the era of His Majesty the King. She congratulated Zainal on receiving the title of the best political achievement for Arab women in 2018, which came in recognition of the achievements of Bahraini women and their efforts in the field of political participation, noting the importance of the national responsibilities of the Representatives Council Speaker. She wished the Council's members success in performing their duty and to achieve the interests of the citizens in coordination with the country's plans and future endeavors. The speaker hailed the democratic march in the kingdom, which embodied the modern aspect of the people and basis of democratic reform project of His Majesty the King, noting the vital role of the SCW to support the development march of Bahraini women and the course of national development. Zainal also noted that the next phase of the council's work will be marked by new aspects of consultation and coordination with the SCW through building on the success achieved and overcoming all challenges to maintain the legislative and legal development that support Bahraini women and families. Her Royal Highness, wife of His Majesty the King and President of the Supreme Council for Women, Princess Sabiha bint Ibrahim Al Khalifa, received today the special envoy at the Royal Court, Samira Rajab, who presented her with a copy of her book, Arabs at the Crossroads. Her Royal Highness commended the efforts of Samira Rajab, which emanate from her rich media experience and keenness to contribute to enriching the intellectual and cultural movement in Bahrain and across the Arab world through intellectual production and objective and forward-looking analysis. The SCW President stressed that the intensification of Bahraini women's presence in the cultural and intellectual fields confirms Bahrain's status as a platform for opinion, science, and knowledge, praising the widespread appreciation of the book by those interested in Arab affairs and global politics. The Royal Court Special Envoy expressed her appreciation to Her Royal Highness for her interest in public affairs locally, regionally, and internationally, lauding her constant care for Bahraini women, which has reflected positively on the status of women in society and increased their contributions in many fields. She asserted that her book sheds light on the nature and the current and future problems and challenges faced by the Arab region amid the regional and global geopolitical changes, stressing the importance of Arab cohesion to face the international changes and arrangements as a unified bloc. Royal Guard Commander Major General His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa received today Commander of Special Operations Command Central Rear Admiral Wayman Howard and his accompanying delegation in the presence of Royal Guard Special Force Commander Lieutenant Colonel His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Highness Sheikh Nasser welcomed the delegation and discussed with them ways to further enhance joint military cooperation. He praised the bilateral historic ties and the cooperation in all fields. Royal Guard Commander Major General His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, along with Royal Guard Special Force Commander Lieutenant Colonel His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, met with the Commander of the French Forces stationed in the UAE and the Indian Ocean Commander General Didier Maltaire and his accompanying delegation. His Highness expressed appreciation to the Commander General and discussed the possibility of military cooperation between the two countries and improving their bilateral ties. The President of Bahrain Basketball Association, His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Ali Al Khalifa, patronized the draw of the third edition of the Khalifa bin Salman Basketball Cup for men. His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Ali affirmed that the Khalifa bin Salman Cup has come to represent a fixture in Bahraini basketball and that it reflects the keen interest of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, in creating a conducive environment for athletic achievements. His Highness said that the cup has become a milestone in Bahrain sports and a suitable place to confirm the success achieved by Bahraini basketball and its development in an effective and clear manner in its administrative and technical systems. The patronage of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister proves his keenness to support the sports movement in the kingdom and create the perfect atmosphere in order to ensure the continuation of sports achievements. He said that the first and second edition of the Khalifa bin Salman Basketball Cup has received strong participation from the national clubs who presented exciting levels in order to win the trophy. His Highness wished the national club success and expressed his appreciation for the contributions of national companies in supporting the event. The Minister of Electricity and Water Affairs, Dr. Abdul Hussein Mirza, along with the Minister of Transportation and Telecommunications, Kamal bin Ahmed Muhammad, CEO of Electricity and Water Authority, Sheikh Nawaf bin Ibrahim Al Khalifa, and CEO of the Supreme Council for Environment, Dr. Muhammad bin Dana, participated in Abu Dhabi Week for Sustainability and Sheikh Zayed Award for Sustainability. The event opened yesterday in the presence of UAE Deputy President, Prime Minister, and Dubai Ruler, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, and Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi and Deputy Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces, Sheikh Mohammed Ahmed bin Zayed Al Nahyan, as well as officials and representatives from various countries. Dr. Mirza conveyed the greetings of His Majesty the King, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince to the UAE leaders. The minister stressed the importance of participating in this annual event with the participation of more than 40,000 people from 175 countries gathering up to exchange views and expertise to achieve sustainability for a better future. He added that the event tackles energy topics, ways to achieve sustainability, and strategies regarding renewable energies, especially through the technological development and the use of solar energy. The minister affirmed that the outcomes of the event will benefit Bahrain and achieve sustainable energy, provide options for renewable energy, and encourage individuals and institutions to invest in this field. Dr. Mirza then visited the accompanying exhibition, which exhibits techniques for renewable energy and countries' experiences in diversifying energy sources. The Minister of Works, Municipalities Affairs and Urban Planning, Assam Khalaf, chaired the sixth meeting of the Government Buildings Maintenance Committee to discuss the reduction of operating expenditures in accordance with the initiative to reduce the government's operating expenses within the six initiatives of the fiscal balance program aimed at balancing expenditure and government revenues for 2022. The meeting examined 82 government requests and 44 applications were approved after all the applications were studied in depth. The minister also directed a team from the committee to visit the ministries from which maintenance requests were received. He noted that the committee will submit a circular in this regard to all government authorities, especially with regard to periodic and frequent maintenance work. The minister stressed that such efforts should contribute to the sustainability of the financial situation and stability in order to increase the pace of development for the benefit of the country and the citizens, and to establish a solid base that ensures the sustainability of national resources. The National Bureau for Taxation has launched a new service for consumers through its website, which allows the possibility of verifying that any company, commercial institution or business has a certificate of registration for value-added purposes and thus imposing it on goods and services subject to tax under the provisions of the law. The launch of the new service comes within the framework of ensuring the interests of the consumer and the right to obtain the correct information, as well as the creation of all factors necessary for the success of the process of the initial launch of value-added tax and implemented with the utmost transparency. The new service will serve as an effective tool for the immediate monitoring of any irregularities in the field of the initial stage of the application of value added in relation to the implementation of the tax by non-registered bodies. Under the new service, the consumer will be able to verify whether the companies are registered to collect the value added tax from consumers by entering the VAT number of the tax number or the commercial registration number, or through the QR code survey that is presented on the tax certificate. In the case of registration and validity, the data of the entity will appear after the search. In case of non-registration, the registrar shall immediately inform the National Bureau for Taxation. The National Bureau for Taxation announced that the tax exemption logo entitled VAT-free will be distributed across various establishments in order to place the logo on goods and services that are not subject to VAT. This new measure builds on the government's efforts to strengthen consumer protection and transparency and ensuring the correct implementation of VAT. The NBT stressed the importance of the various establishments to adopt this measure, making sure the logo is clear and visible to consumers. In this regard, the NBT for Gulf Taxation further stressed the importance of clearly placing the VAT certificate of registration that entitles these entities to collect VAT and products and services that are subject to it.